if the change doesn't come from the haves, the change has to come from the have-nots, and the have-nots change is much more revolutionary.
This country is the most influencing country in the world. Everybody wants to be like the marketing that's come through the media from here. So I felt that if I put my energy here and affect a little bit of change, it will ripple to the rest of the world. So I'm living here now. I have concerns. I have concerns about the educational system, about the superficiality of values for children. But everybody else is imitating America. If this population would open to its spiritual destiny, then one could live anywhere in their spiritual destiny.
When I look at what is, I assume it will get considerably darker before it turns around. I mean, if we're going to talk about trauma as a motivator.
It could be that way, and I also have hope.
Yeah.
And I know what you say. This conversation I have at home many times a day.
Yeah.
What are we doing here? My wife thinks this is Germany in the 30s.
Right.
She has a more radical view.
Right.
She said, it's hopeless.
Yeah.
So I bring the hope in and said, well, we have to put out as much as we can to maybe put a little sugar in the ocean. I know the ocean is not going to get sweet
yeah.
because of that little sugar, but it might polarize. And I have a hope that is beyond the reasoning of this world. I think there must be at some moment the divine intervention. I don't know what shape it's going to take. Some people think it's going to be a massive landing, and some people think it's going to be a day of darkness and light. All of that could be just wishful thinking.